And we welcome you back here to the ExxonMobil Wesson West Show. Here today at the Cape Harris Country Creek Golf Course down in Franklin, Kentucky, West Strader with noted author Gary P. West.
Just glad to be here. I enjoy hanging out with you because this has sort of become my home away from home. I've played golf three times this year, and all three of them have been down here at Country Creek. Mm-hmm. And Kenny Perry will be glad to know that we've actually paid our green fees down here.
Yeah, so he will.
So it can't get much better than this, unless you're Kenny Perry.
The biggest name in golf right now is Kenny Perry of Franklin, Kentucky, longtime friend. I still call him a kid because I was around when he came up. And Kenny, you were so gracious to spend a little time with us here on the deck at Country Creek. How are you doing?
Tired.
Are you?
Doing great, though. You know, life's changed all of a sudden. You know, everybody looked at me differently, and I'm still the same old guy I've always been.
Still working on cars, too, I
should. Still working on getting grease under my fingernails a little bit. But hadn't had a lot of time to do that. I mean, this has been a whirlwind 3 months for me. You know, I set that goal to make that Ryder Cup team, and, you know, boom, it's happened. It's pretty fantastic.
You took it different than me, I think, based on what I saw you say on TV. I really didn't like it at the time when Azinger said, you're going to have to win a tournament to make my Ryder Cup team. Because I thought at the time, I said, you know, Kenny deserves to be on a Ryder Cup. And yet, if he doesn't win a tournament, what Azinger's saying is he's not going to take it. You turn around and say, that was a challenge to you.
It was probably the single most, you know, thing said to me that woke me up. I just played in Atlanta. I just banked it off the tree against Ruggie Amat in the playoff. It caroms all the way across the green and into the water. And the next day in the paper, I read a quote from Zinger saying, you're going to have to win to be on my Ryder Cup team. And immediately I started thinking different. My head changed. My mental thinking process changed. I was trying to go for top tens. You know, I was just wanting top tens to get as many points as I could to get on that team. And then all of a sudden I said, oh, my goodness, I'm going to have to win. And it was a stab in the heart. That's the way I said it in the paper because it actually woke me up. I said, okay, I've got to win. And I said, I've got great stretch of tournaments coming up. I've got Colonial. I've got Memorial. I've got the Buick. You know, I've got tournaments I've had success at. And I was looking. And I said, well, you know, this is great. And I said, I'm playing probably as good as I've ever played in my career. And I said, I did take it as a challenge. It was a personal challenge to me. And, you know what, he helped wake me up a little bit. And, you know, now I've put three wins on the board, and rest is history. You know, I've made that team.
Kenny, how does it happen? I mean, when most players that are playing the regular tour are at your age, 47, 48 years old, they're in what's called the twilight of their career. And all of a sudden, you're playing the best golf you've ever played, and you're among the top two or three golfers in the world right now. How does that happen? Where do you get it from within to bring your game to that level? Has it always been there, but it was just a management situation?
I owe a lot to genetics. You know, I'm a big guy. I'm strong. I'm physically, you know, I had my knee surgery in 06 that really slowed me down. But you know what? It's just experience. It's just patience. It's being out there all these years, and I don't get nervous. You know, I get anxious, but I don't really get too nervous and tore up over the situation anymore like I used to.
You know, and that's a thing that kind of every Kentuckian is watching every putt you make. I've had people tell me they have to leave the room. You know, you have maybe one of those four or five footers, and then the putt, and they've got a little more problem.
Yeah, just keep trying.
And I'm sitting here thinking, and you make most of them, but when you miss one, I see this unbelievable control that you have. That we've seen the Woody Austins and the Rory Sabatinis and those guys scream and want to break their putters and all this stuff. But you seem, and you've got to be maybe burning within and you have everything under control, but it's just one of those things I don't know how you do it.
Well, it's just, you know what, I've been there, done that.
Yep.
You know what, it's a kind of situation to where my whole career I've normally missed. And for whatever reason, I'll tell you a story about my putter. It's a great story. I belong to Bent Pine down in Vero Beach, Florida. I used to go down there in the wintertime a little bit to practice to get ready for the each year. And I was down there last November, and one of the members came up to me, had this putter in his hand, held it out to me and says, you really need to putt with this putter. It's really going to help you. And he never cracked a smile. He just looked at me deadpan seriously, and it stunned me. You know, I've never had that done before. And I said, Paul, really? Paul Hargarten was his name. And I said, okay, thank you very much. I grabbed a putter. I was nice and polite, took it away from him, put it in my bag, and when he wasn't looking, it ended up in the trunk of my car. But you know what? I've putted with old Rossi One forever, and I was putting lousy down there. And next thing you know, I go grab that putter, and I putted great with it in the shark shootout. And I was like, man, I said, that was different. And next thing you know, I put it in play, and I won $4.4 million with it this year, three tournaments. And they asked me, what are you going to do for Paul for helping you with that putter? And I said, how about 10 bucks and a Coke?
And it'd be a good deal for both of you. A good deal is when both parties are happy.
But, you know, that has been the biggest difference in my game. I've always been every year top 10 in total driving, you know, greens and accuracy, top 10 in greens and reg. I've had a great gift. God's given me a great gift to hit the golf ball. I mean, I have great hands, good feel for the ability to get the golf ball around the golf course, but I never could seem to make the clutch 4 and 5 footers when you make it. And for whatever reason this year, I'm making probably 99% of those things. I think I read a stat at the Buick or whatever. I think I was 46 for 46 from 6 foot or 8 foot and in.
Yeah, I saw that.
Or some kind of crazy. I mean, that's impossible.
And you were in the in the John Deere, didn't you?
Yeah,
have a good put.
I put it great in all of them. So
yeah,
it's just been phenomenal how.
And what they do, you haven't changed your stance.
No, I still got the wide stance.
And a lot of times, I think these golfers, us, you know, we're pretty good here, Gary.
Yeah,
me with my 20, I'm maintaining my 22 handicap, Kenny. You change the way you grip the ball, the club, you change your stance, you change all of this kind of stuff, you know, you stayed with it. Now, you used to have some eye problems.
I did. I've had 2 LASIK surgeries, and now I still wear contacts. Steve Compton put me in, it's called a LASIK contact lens. You know, once you have LASIKs, your eyes are now flat and you can't wear a normal contact lens, which I didn't know at the time. So now I've got a lens that's soft, you know, it's probably soft, 32nd of an inch is a soft around the hard center. It's crazy. And I have to wear those now for distance seeing. They're working, you know. My vision's better. I feel comfortable with them. They don't hurt my eyes. And that might be another thing why I'm putting better. I'm actually seeing the line a little bit better.
We're with PGA golfer Kenny Perry here at Kenny Perry's Country Creek Golf Course in Franklin, Kentucky. And we're going to continue our visit here with Kenny in just a moment, so stay with us. You're listening to the ExxonMobil Wesson West Show.